Are y'all going up to the sheriff? Y'all waiting? Do we need to wait on him? Item one, which is now item 17. Doug, you can take the lead on this. I'll let Tim guys.
Sure, I'll talk to that.
Yeah, again, Mr. Chairman and fellow commissioners, I apologize, Sheriff got tied up in the meeting. We're here today to, as you know, we're hiring for the new jail and courthouse. We're here to ask that you release the funds that have been set aside for hiring of those two facilities.
But basically, you only want height to funds, correct?
So I think that's what was on the form. Yeah. But we'd like to ask for all of the funds.
We asked it for.
It's changed since agenda review.
Yeah,
they came over and asked for half of the new jail funds.
You want the whole $1.8 million instead of $900,000?
Correct. When did y'all decide that, may I ask?
I'm sorry?
Did y'all decide that this afternoon or this morning? Or?
That was this morning, yes.
Yeah. And may we ask what made the decision change?
Basically, we're in the middle of hiring. We've got a lot of people coming in.
Okay.
And we're going to control the funds for the hiring process, so we'd like to get them all released.
So, but you may not use all this fund, correct? You're going to say you're going to control it, so do you have
Takes
it now and end of year, you're going to use all this?
We're hiring. You know, we're going to hire the number we need to fill these two facilities, but I don't foresee us using all those funds.
We do consider for all expenditures for the new jail, new courthouse, for the training, the hiring, and everything else is still being maintained in our system separately, tracked separately. So it's not going to be merged in with just a regular operating budget. We keep complete transparency and have it to a point where everything we're spending. What we're running into is, for example, now all the DS1s that we have budgeted are already hired for. That we currently have budgeted. All the new hires are now into using this money in order to make it work with the county processes in the system. There's examples of converting different positions. There's a lot of, for lack of a better term, shell games that go on in the accounting process to document it, that once this money's released, and then we have to move everything back. So it becomes a lot of moving money around, but by having these line items funded now, it avoids us having to move stuff around. So if there is money left, then absolutely, we're not going to spend it on something else. It's going to be related to the jail and the courthouse.
This will help you keep a clean line item to show exactly what it costs.
Exactly.
To man.
What?
To man, to staff, to uniform, to equip, all of these things, to train all of these people.
I remember last year in the budgeting process and finance committee that we talked about what projections were shown would be needed at the new jail, and that it would be a lot of trial and error until you get over there. I mean, are y'all using a lot of precaution that you're not over hiring?
Oh, absolutely.
I mean, that you won't be hiring a lot of people that won't actually be needed.
Correct.
What are you anticipating at this point in time for extra personnel that you're hiring to man this jail over what you have presently?
We're budgeted at, what, 87?
87
FTEs or full-time equivalent employees.
Between both facilities?
Correct, both.
In addition to what you already have?
Correct. That's what's budgeted. Whether or not we'll use it or need it, it's yet to be seen. Again, it's going to be, as Commissioner Mills said, trial and error as we're doing it.
And we had set money aside?
Yeah, we've got. Don't we have this in the budget, David?
Yeah.
It's in reserve.
It's in reserve.
I knew what the 87 was. I didn't know if y'all, at this point in time, I've done enough research to see if it needed this still 87 or if
not.
It's not even a number yet.
Doug, the consultants that's working with your group think that it'll be less than that?
No, not necessarily.
So that is the number they're thinking.
I think it was more.
Yes, they thought it was more. This was cut down.
We cut it way down.
This year's budget.
Right, because they're not doing anything like the first quarter.
We cut it. Like start out over 100.
The original request is 131, 132, and it was reduced to 87. Now the funding that's in place is for a portion of 2015.
Correct.
But to access it any time during the year and then hire as they need to hire. Mm-hmm. Makes perfect sense for training purposes and otherwise.
That's what we said that for.
I'd make a motion that we approve the budget adjustment for the Sheriff's Office for expenditures related to jail courthouse project from designated reserve funds in an amount not to exceed $1,850,000.
Second.
And does that need to be time sensitive?
Yes, it does. I'm sorry.
Second. Or that my motion is time sensitive.
Second, time sensitive.
Make the amendment.
Yeah. Have a motion second. Any other discussion?
If the main motion is approved, passes, that the sheriff notify us immediately when that account is drawn down to zero.
Second.
We have a motion and second for amendment to the regular motion.
Do you anticipate that happening in 2014?
Spending all of it in 2014, it's going to depend on the hiring, the training. So
but I mean, if we go over, it's, are we coming back for more money, or if we go under?
I think we have a history of giving money back that we haven't used. Or don't need.
I don't think Mr. Ball's trying to. He just wants to know, since we are as a board of commissioners, our power to look after the overall budget of the county, it's just nice to know how it's going, that's all.
Of the county, not of the sheriff's office.
That's exactly correct.
Right.
So if you're running out of money, then at some point might be going, okay, they may be looking for some more.
Well, yeah, if we were to get to that point, obviously well ahead of time, we would be not coming in that day saying we're out of money, we need it.
But you did it today.
What did we do today? No, we didn't do it today. This is money set aside.
It was set aside today.
I got it.
So, you want to know that in calendar year 2014, or
it's this
18
year.
Months from now?
Yeah, in this year, okay. Calendar year 2014.
It happens to be.
So if you
training for this year.
Yeah,
it's everything. It's hiring, training, uniforms.
But it goes over in the calendar year 2015. Correct?
Not this training part of it.
Right, we didn't do the budget yet for 2015.
I know, but I thought we had some.
Mm-hmm. Well, I don't want to speak to the sheriff's office, but what would happen in one of my departments like this, if you funded positions for a portion of 2014, those positions would show up on the 2015 budget as a full year.
Mm-hmm. So we just haven't got there yet.
We just haven't gotten there yet. Yes, sir. Now, that may change if they decide they need more in 2015 or fewer in 2015, then that's the number that would present during the preliminary budget.
Would correct. That be difficult for y'all to let the Board of Commissioners know?
If and when you draw it?
That's what Jim said.
No, I don't see an issue with that. I mean, we're fully transparent.
You say these numbers would be a whole separate line. He doesn't want to mix the numbers.
And it's tracked in our budgeting system as that. I'm sure you guys probably even have access to it. Jamie Payne has it tracked with the designator at the end, whether it's court or jail.
Yes.
So you can pull it up at any time and look.
That's on the account. So they're being charged to accounts separate from your regular salaries.
Correct.
So we can see that.
So you have that transparency.
David, you could pull that up for us, couldn't you?
You could pull it up anytime you want.
The accounts this resolution moves from the reserve into these accounts have a special designation of jail or courthouse separate from their regular budgeted salaries in the budget right now.
So Mr. Gruen.
So they'll be tracked separately.
So while I'm sheriff's department.
I withdraw my motion.
I withdraw the second first name.
Okay.
David, just real quick, Mr. Gruen, do you want this resolution approved? This is part of this?
Yeah, and two counts, either the motion needed to include the resolution or state it as such, and then I was trying to clarify when we wrote the other motion that do we simply double each of the accounts? This was prepared at half the amount. This resolution, so
right. So
I
just
want to clarify, we just double into each of the lines here.
Correct.
Okay, and then we're okay if they include that in the motion.
Well, Brian said the motion was $1,850,000.
Okay, and we had a resolution line by line item as they gave us
for half
that much. I'm just going to double each of the lines if I just make sure it was okay with their office.
All right,
$1,850,000.
I just want to make sure that Commissioner Tam, your motion included this resolution. But your dollar amount.
There you go.
It can be, yes. I didn't speak to the resolution, but
that I know I'm
I
asking.
I thought that would be make it more confusing since they only had it.
All right. So I should withdraw my second.
I would. I'd like you to do it again, Commissioner Tam, and just approve the resolution, but double the dollar amounts in the resolution.
And it is Exhibit A.
That'd make me feel better.
Well, that's what this is all about, isn't it?
Oh, no.
This does not need to be time sensitive.
Yes, it does.
It does need to be time sensitive. Well, I'm going to make a time sensitive motion then, that we approve budget adjustment for the sheriff's office for expenditures related to jail courthouse project from designated reserve funds in an amount not to exceed $1,850,000, and that we adopt this resolution, Exhibit A, as presented to us in our books for twice the dollar amount, which is, once again, $1,850,000.
Yes, sir.
Second, time sensitive.
Have a motion and second for a time sensitive item one for approval. Any other questions? All in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion carries 5-0.
Thank you.